My name is Dr. Joseph Durrani, and I am the chair of cardiovascular surgery at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. I am also a pediatric cardiovascular surgeon with a particular interest in Epstein anomaly. The institution has had a long-standing interest in this diagnosis and has become a personal area of expertise in my practice, and I would like to follow up with the initial video with the most frequently asked questions that I get from patients today. The first has to do with early and late outcome. The risk related to surgery now is less than 2%, and in many situations, it is 1%. When patients are operated on at the right time, and we are operating earlier and earlier in the current era, the risk of surgery is low. From a late outcome standpoint, the durability of the valve repair that we now have been applying for the last 5 years, the cone technique, the most contemporary and anatomic repair, the results appear to be quite favorable. Valve repair seems to be holding quite steady, and the need for reoperation has been very, very limited and minimized with the current techniques. Follow-up down the road is very important for patients of all ages, whether they be a child or an adult. Particularly with regard to echocardiographic analysis of the valve, exercise testing to examine stamina, and evaluation for arrhythmias. Arrhythmia is the most common late complication with any congenital defect, but much more so for Epstein's anomaly. Needs to have a proper oversight by the proper personnel for a lifetime. The learning curve for the cone operation is quite steep. Our experience now approaches 1,000 patients, more than half of which have had valve repairs. And in the last 5 years now, we are at approximately 125 cone repairs. The ability to apply this operation reproducibly is becoming much more commonplace. And I think the ability to do this over and over again, learn from your own mistakes, apply various modifications to optimize the repair has contributed to our success in recent years. Questions always come up about the neonate. I think in general, if you can avoid surgery for Epstein's anomaly in the neonatal period, you should try and do it. There are situations when it must be done, and the question comes up, feasibility of cone repair. It is possible to do it. I would suggest that it be done on an individualized basis and based on the comfort level of the surgeon involved. Now, another topic that has resulted in many questions in recent years is the ability to re-repair a valve that's already been repaired. This is particularly appealing when the valve repair has been done many years ago or even more than a decade ago. The leaflet tissue thickens and scars, the annular tissue thickens and scars, and the ability to remove leaflet tissue from the ventricular wall, mobilize it, suture together in many ways is facilitated in the setting of previous cardiac surgery because the leaflet tissue and the overall tissue quality is more favorable. Finally, the timing of operation is a question that comes up all the time now. In distant years, we would generally advise operation when symptoms were present. In children, symptoms are often not present unless cyanosis is the presenting symptom. The timing of surgery is being done earlier and earlier now. I think that when there is a high confidence level of being able to apply the cone procedure, which is the most anatomic procedure that can be offered for this diagnosis, a strong argument can be made to offer surgery earlier. This will result in optimizing right ventricular function. It optimizes the ability to do a good tricuspid valve repair. And in our practice now, we are generally advising surgery between 2 and 5 years of age when the anatomy is appropriate to apply the cone procedure. Thanks very much for listening.